everybody, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to talk about the books that I want to read in February, so my February TBR. I'm actually really excited for February as a reading month because January is definitely the month that my reading mood finally improved. So I'm very much looking forward to February to make my reading mood even better and to read more and really find my love for reading again. Also, January was quite busy, and also the first week of February will be quite busy because it's the end of a semester, but then after that, I hopefully things will calm down a little bit. We'll probably still be a bit busy, but anyway, I do think that February is just going to be a very good reading month for me because basically I've just decided it right now that it's going to be. And I do have some very exciting but also very ambitious reading plans, so I think I should just start with this video and tell you all about the books that I'm planning to read. The first book is definitely my highest priority at the moment, and that is The Sun Rising by Samantha Shannon. This is the third book in the Bone Season series, which is all about a young girl named Paige who lives in a sort of alternate version slash dystopian version of our world, where lots of people are clairvoyant, but it's actually illegal to be clairvoyant, and Paige is a dreamwalker, which is a very rare kind of clairvoyance. Much more happens in the series apart from that, because it's just basically a roller coaster ride, especially the first two books. Like, there's so much that is happening. And this is the third book in the series that I really want to read because, first of all, it is time. It has been ages since I finished The Mime Order, which is the second book. But also because this month, the fourth book in the series, The Mask Falling, is finally released. I don't know if it's already released or it's going to be released somewhere in the next couple of days. Will also depend on when I'm actually uploading this video, of course. I'm not the best with actual release dates, and I could have been prepared better for this, but yeah, that's why I do want to read this book, because I really want to read The Mask Falling as well this month. I'm very excited to see what I'm going to think of The Sun Rising. It's a bit thinner, a bit smaller than the other two books in the series. And yeah, I just cannot wait to see how this story is going to continue, because I did really enjoy the first two books. I definitely think there's a lot to it, a lot of amazing characters, and the world building is excellent. I think that's definitely the strongest point of this entire series. So I'm going to read The Sun Rising, and then after that, like, the second book that I do want to read this month is naturally The Mask Falling, because I sort of want to keep up with this like series high. When I'm reading the third book, I just want to immediately read the fourth book as well, so I can continue with the story and I have a lot of that story at once. And I'm also very curious, like, the new release, what are people going to think of it? What am I going to think of it? I just want to sort of, I don't want to have any FOMO. I don't want to be left out when everybody is reading a new book, and I want to read the new book as well. So that is why I want to read like The Sun Rising and then The Mask Falling as well. Those are the first two books on my TBR for this month, and I think those are like the highest priority right now. And then I'm also planning to actually finish a book series this month, which is something that very rarely happens with me these days. But I want to read A Sky Beyond the Storm by Saba Tahir, which is the final book in the Ember in the Ashes series. So I have been rereading all the books from the Ember in the Ashes series this month, so I'm completely like caught up and I know everything again, which was a very good case, because there were things. I've read the books before, but some big plot twist still came as a surprise to me, which is something else. But anyway, I have done that now. I remember everything again. So now I can read The Sky, or A Sky Beyond the Storm, which is the final book, and I can finish this series. I really do enjoy the series. I do think that the first book is the very best in the series. I don't know how good the last one is going to be, but I don't think there's like a single bad book so far. It's very epic. I'm very much invested in all of these characters, especially after my reread. So I'm going to read A Sky Beyond the Storm. I'm very excited for it. Like, I do really, like, I need to finish another book series. It never happens, and I really want to sort of keep up my game a bit when it comes to series. Not even keeping up, because in order to keep it up, I should have done it before. So maybe, yeah, I don't know. I want to finish more series, and this is probably a good step towards that. Then I have something completely different, because I have a thriller book, and that is Girl A by Abigail Dean. This book is about a young girl named Lex Gracie, and she was imprisoned and tortured in her parents' house of horror. So she was abused by her parents as well as all of her siblings. But Lex managed to escape and to free her siblings. But now, within like all of the news outlets, she's known as Girl A, because that is often the case when it concerns a minor. But then sometime later, Lex's mother dies in prison, and she is left that house of horrors, and that brings up a lot of memories. So this is a book that I recently got because it just, the premise sounded so interesting to me, and I suddenly felt a real craving for a thriller, and this one just sounded like it would be perfect, so that is why I do want to read it this month. I think it is nice, especially because I'm planning to read so many fantasy books, to also have something else, to sort of switch up genres a little bit. I feel like that helps when I tend to get into a reading slump, and I don't want to get into a reading slump again, so something like this seems like it's going to be very tension build. And of course fantasy can also be tension build, but sometimes it can be a bit slow, and this does not sound like a slow book at all. It sounds very exciting but also horrifying, of course, when it comes to like the subject of the book and the topics. I personally really like to read those kinds of books, but I can understand that it's not for everybody because it sounds like it's going to be very extreme. But I'm so in the mood for that, so I'm going to read this one this month. And yeah, it is nice to have a bit of something different. Also, I think this is sort of a new release, not sure. This is one of those books that I just came about when I was scrolling through Amazon and I thought it looked interesting, and I haven't heard any reviews about it yet. And I want to keep it that way. I want to go into this book blindly, which I'm going to do this month. So yeah, very, very curious to see what I'm going to think of this one. I think it will be a good one, but of course, you never know. But I really do hope I will not be disappointed. And then again, in the trend of having some different kinds of genres in this TBR, I also want to read Wonder by RJ Palacio. This is a middle grade book about a young boy named August who has a facial disfigurement. And he goes to public school for the very first time, which of course brings out a lot of problems and maybe some bullying. I'm not completely sure if that is what's going to happen, probably, because that is usually the case in these kinds of stories, but I could be wrong. This is a very beloved middle grade book. It's supposed to be very beautiful and sad, but also like so many things at once. It is a book that has been on my, I guess, mental TBR for ages, but I didn't own it until a couple of months ago, and I cannot wait to start reading this because I want to see what all the hype is about. I want to see if I'm going to be emotional about it as well. Also middle grade, something a bit different, something a bit more, I guess, realistic, you know, with all the fantasy stories and then like a very exciting thriller story. This one seems a bit more down to earth when it comes to like the topic subject, even though it's probably still going to be emotional, and I don't know exactly what to expect, but I do know that the reviews are very positive, and that makes me very excited to pick it up. And I want to make it a habit to read middle grade more regularly, so this one sounds to be perfect for that. And yeah, I feel like it's just like, after so many years, it is finally time for me to read it. So I'm going to make that happen this month. And then for the final book of this TBR, for my February TBR, I want to read Royal Assassin by Robin Hobb. This is the second book in the Farseer trilogy, which is all about a boy named Fitz, who is the bastard son of a prince. And he grows up while being trained as an assassin at the court, and it is high fantasy. This is the second book in the series, and I read the first book in January. I really enjoyed the first book. I really enjoyed the writing style. It is a bit slower at times, but I really like that there was so much time with building up the characters and like the world and everything. So yeah, I read the first book, and the thing is with me, very often when I read the first book of a series, I'm like, oh yeah, I really enjoyed it, I should continue with it, and then I just don't. And that is a habit that I really want to break, and that is why I'm planning to read this book, the second book, already this month. I really want to be better with keeping up with series, because I don't know why, because I get so distracted by like so many other books, so I guess I do know why. So many book series that I've started, I read the first book and I'm like, yeah, I will go to the second one sometime in the future, and then I just don't do it for maybe a year or so. But now I actually do have the second book in the series. I already have the third book in the series as well, and the entire trilogy is already out. Like, it has been out for a very long time, and I enjoyed the first book, so why not continue with the second book so that I can see what's going to happen next, how this entire story is going to go. So I guess I'm also making this video to hold myself accountable to that, and then maybe I will look back to this in a month and I still have not read it yet, which could be possible knowing myself, but it's not my intention. So yeah, let's keep up with series more regularly. And yeah, this one, it just, I loved it so much. Also, just imagine me like, this is actually the third book and not, no, I think I checked it. That would be something for me, that I'm holding up the third book and it's actually the, like, not the second book, but anyways. Also really happy to finally have been introduced to Robin Hobb's writing and her books, because there are many more that I can read, so I want to do that. But first, finishing the Farseer trilogy should be a priority, so I will do that. Hopefully soon I will read this book in February. I promise I will do it. I will just make it happen. And those were my reading plans for February, my February TBR, and I'm actually really, really excited about it. It has been so long since I've done a monthly TBR because, as I mentioned before, I've been very much out of it. I've been very much in a reading slump. I haven't been doing reading wrap-ups either, but I will start doing those again. My January reading wrap-up will be there sometime in the future. Like, I don't know when, because again, it's a very busy week. It's the last week of the semester, but I will do one. I will start those again. And yeah, doing TBRs actually already makes me really excited about reading. So I guess it's also a good way to get out of a reading slump, just to film a TBR, at least for me. And you know, maybe it will not help at all and I will be very excited, but I won't read that much anyway. But there are many exciting book series for this month. I want to finish some series, I want to continue with some series, I want to read some other stuff, and I cannot wait. It's going to be a good month. I've just decided that it's going to be a good month, and I feel in a very good mood right now, so hopefully that will continue as well. But then this was it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, maybe subscribe, give it a like, or leave a comment, thumbs up, whatever. As always, I would really appreciate it. And if you do leave a comment, please let me know what you are planning to read this month, if you're excited for a new release or something, or if you are reading a book that has been on your TBR for ages. Just please let me know. I would love to hear, and then we can have a little talk in the comments. But for now, hopefully I will see you again very soon in one of my next videos. Bye!